The Satsuma Rebellion was the last of many samurai revolts against the new Japanese imperial government, 9 years into the Meiji era. The modernization of Japan under the new government, led by Emperor Meiji the Great, brought about many cultural changes, as well as changes to the Japanese language, dress, and the country's society. Not only that, but the samurai class was no longer looked upon as a privileged social status. And the Hattori Edict, meaning sword abolishment edict, meant that no one except police officers and military officials could carry weapons. Even the samurai were forbidden from carrying weapons. If anyone were to break this law, their weapon or weapons would be confiscated. Saigo Takamori, a high-ranking leader in the Satsuma domain, supported the country's reform at first, but soon became concerned with the government's excessive political corruption. The slogan of Saigo's rebel movement was Shinsei Kodoku, meaning new government, high morality. In the Saigon Run debate of 1873, Saigo proved to be a strong advocate for war with Korea. During the debate, Saigo offered to provoke a casus belli, meaning a case of war, by going to Korea and being as disrespectful as possible, so that the Koreans would be forced to kill him. Saigo felt that a war with Korea would be very beneficial for Japan, and would allow the samurai to have a proper death. Saigo's plan was rejected, so he resigned from all government positions in an act of protest, and returned to his hometown of Kagoshima. Many other ex-samurai of the domain class who were serving in the military and police forces then followed Saigo's protest. In 1874, Saigo established a private academy in Kagoshima to help take care of his fellow ex-samurai. The academy soon grew to 132 branches. The students were taught academics, however some of the required skills were weapons training and instruction in tactics. These were emphasized with Bushido, meaning the way or the moral of the warrior, and Hagekure, meaning hidden by the leaves or hidden leaves, which is a practical and spiritual guide for a warrior. Saigo also started an artillery school for training with large munitions-based weaponry. The schools were very reminiscent of paramilitary political organizations. They even received support from Oyama Sunuyoshi, the governor of Satsuma, who even appointed some of the ex-samurai to political offices where they came to dominate the Kagoshima government. Saigo was so successful and support was so high for him that the Satsuma domain was able to secede from the central government by the end of 1876. However, Saigo's success brought great concern to Tokyo. The government, having just dealt with small yet dangerous samurai revolts in Kyushu, was afraid of a possible samurai rebellion led by the great Saigo Takamori. In December of 1876, the Meiji government sent a police officer named Nakahara Haiso and 57 other men to investigate reports of subversive activities and unrest. They were soon captured and tortured until they were forced to confess their true intentions. The men confessed to being spies sent to assassinate Saigo, however Nakahara denied the truth behind the confession. The Satsuma used the failed assassination attempt as justification for a rebellion, claiming it would be to protect Saigo. On January 3rd, 1877, the Meiji government sent a warship to Kagoshima to remove the weapons stockpiled at the Kagoshima arsenal out of fear of a possible rebellion. This action provoked conflict between the government and Satsuma forces. Outraged by the government's aggressive tactics, 50 students from Saigo's academy raided the Sumuda arsenal. They were successful in their attack, and they were able to carry off many weapons. Over the next 3 days, over 1,000 of Saigo's students staged raids on the Imperial Naval Yards and other government arsenals. Impressed with the students' successful raids, Saigo was convinced to come out of his semi-retirement to lead the Satsuma Rebellion against the central government. In February 1877, the Meiji government sent Hayashi Tamayuki, an official with the Home Ministry, along with Admiral Kawamura Sumiyoshi, in the warship Takao, to figure out the situation. Satsuma Governor Oyama Isenyoshi explained that the rebellion was in response to the failed assassination attempt on Saigo. Oyama asked that Admiral Kawamura, Saigo's cousin, come ashore to help calm the situation. After Oyama left, a flotilla of small ships carrying Imperial soldiers tried to board Takao by force, but were held back. The next day, Hayashi told Oyama that he could not permit Kawamura to go on shore during such a chaotic situation, and that the attack on Takao constituted an act of treason. Returning to Kobe on February 12th, Hayashi met with General Yamagata Aritoma and Ito Hirabumi, where it was decided that the Japanese Imperial Army would need to be sent to Kagoshima to stop the rebellion from spreading to areas of the country that were sympathetic to Saigo. The same day, Saigo met with his lieutenants Kurino Toshiaki and Shinohara Kunimoto and told them his plan and marched to Tokyo to confront the government. Saigo rejected many volunteers and did not attempt to contact any of the other domains to request their support. Saigo didn't even leave any troops at Kagoshima to secure his base against any attacks. Saigo wore his army uniform to aid in the air illegality. Saigo and his army of samurai marched north through the deepest snowfall that Satsuma had experienced in over 50 years, which, because of its commonality with the weather that greeted those setting out to enact the Meiji Restoration 9 years earlier, was interpreted by some as a sign of divine support.